He's got the music, if you want to click on the music and see which music he's chosen for this part of the article. This is what Dr. Ladd does for us. Again, he writes content for us. And this is his latest excerpt from some of his latest writing. Jeffrey Ladd, COCC, afterword by the author and some particular words on the genre called memoirs. Dr. Ladd's writing his memoirs. This is another chapter that he added. You have before you a sizable chunk of the life story for the Jeffrey Ladd Lamp, born feisty and frailing, determined limbs in Maine, according to his father, Donald Marshall Ladd, February 16th, 1940. I thought this story worth writing before I had written a single word. I still don't, having now written a good many words. The only thing that is significant, significantly different, is that you are now rendering the judgment on my craft. And if I told you, your opinion doesn't matter to me, for it most assuredly does. Thus, the very first and crucial thing to be enumerated here that is quite different, even unique, is my email address. Dr. J. Ladd, the doctor, is the only email address I have or expect to have. And it is my privilege to give it to you with the sincere hope you will share your thoughts on this book and the 19 previous volumes to enlighten, to instruct, to befriend. For the loyalty engendered by these millions of published words is humbling and a thrill that never dwindles or diminishes. A different right from the start, will notice that I have not told my story sequentially. It is because real life is not sequential, and I wanted truth. So rather, it is episode, a veritable popcorn popper of desperate events, some related, a few even sequential, most not even remotely. In other words, we all live in a cauldron of disconnected events, a hodgepodge nicely summed up in this observation. Life is what happens when you're making other plans. This way of presenting my life and times may perplex you, confuse, irritate, even exasperate, until you consider the last day or two of your own life. How much was well ordered? Just so, exactly the way you planned and wanted. I think we both know the answer to that. I wanted to write my life the way it occurred, not as I might have wished. Your life is as spontaneous, unplanned, helter-skelter, and uncontrollable as mine. I merely had the audacity and opportunity to tell it as it happened, written live on screen. Have you ever wondered how writers spin their tales, where they are when they do so, how they do so, and how we take it from ourselves with the Herculean task and boldness to change the world, one carefully selected word at a time? Here, I'm not merely audacious, but one man, suing generous and proud of it. From day one, when I began to work on this considerable project, not just think about it, I did something no other significant writer has ever done. I wrote this book live and in front of a very considerable number of worldprophet.com customers, literally littered wildly all over the world, well over 2 million strong, carried even the greater, daunting number, YouTube and many other communication titans of this wide age. Thus, at any time of their day or night, they might venture by only to see me at work, the full panoply of authorship in all its glorious and habitual discipline apparent. I got the universal reputation for being up and at my exacting task 24 hours a day. It was never true, of course, but I saw no reason to say otherwise. So are the greatest legends born. So do these legends take root, grow, and become the most tenacious truth. I am now on this path, curious to see where it takes me, for I am a person of history, even if only for a moment, as indeed we all are. How I constructed this book, block by block. Always the objective of this book was not merely to crush you with one fact, nor how important. Oh, no, no. I do not believe in that kind of standard, pedestrian history. Rather, whenever possible, I strive to bring you into the event, thus giving it a you and there feeling. Oh, for I like the description even better, a fly on the wall feeling. I want you to experience the event as I did. It's not an easy thing, the task of a master. To achieve this objective, I work hard, gather more facts on the matter I'm right about than I can possibly use. Gathering of abundance is done on purpose because at this stage, I should where my story is going or what I did. I learned this technique from poor old mom, who applied it first to painting. I recall when she was telling me that a figure painter had to paint his picture so that the viewer could see there's a real body underneath. It's anatomy. Paint it accurately, meticulously, and even if it were entirely cut by elaborate costume or radiant skin, it had to be no skimping or shortcuts allowed. The same is true of the best writing and incident therein. You might not have your subject's clothes, how he played with his dog. Much less write these facts, but you knew them, and show the truth of what you wrote. And remember this, the writers always know such, and know it is far superior to fact and complete accuracy. If you don't know what I mean, it is because you are not yet, and may never be, a writer worth reading. Practice harder. Practice more. Not only what is rendered, but what is not. Gathering your information. Writing, last thing you do as a writer. There's much more to it, or you will write more than you. First, on a counter, organize your papers and your brain. As you know, consists of 1,900 pounds of rare, dazzling blue or royal quartzite, a precious stone. It is shimmering now underneath the chandelier at 4:50 a.m. this morning. It is practical. It was wildly expensive. It soothes and rhythm that Keats was right, and I am happy, of course. It is always with greatest possible importance, from detailed in-progress notes helping to establish the proof positive provenance of my late master to a blurred receipt for that entirely forgettable hamburger I got last with predictable results. The only possible justification being a well-worn saying, information is useful at a point. Gather here all information applicable to your chance. Make sure this contains all background material and those aha notes which can and do pop up at odd times and places, and which are so easy to fit to your considerable consternation and dread. Here you should focus on just the chapter you are writing, editing, copying, and in this connection, you should write no more than a couple of paragraphs before saving your. It's absolutely essential and may very well save you from the greatest false any writer can take the longer groups. Note, be sure to keep all drafts in the folder while your opus is in progress. Throw away nothing, absolutely nothing. I've already told you everything is useful at a point. Let Eureka be your guide. Now, or better yet, let your writer's team do so. You do have one, don't you? Well, oh my, I am looking right now in the face of Pastor Michael Harris of Danville, Virginia. He's a member of my team. What does he do? First of all, he is a sentinel, experienced, thoroughly adult presence. He sees what I write, what I first wrote, what was then edited in and edited out. He sees what my brain is considering and what has now been dropped, at least for now. But this is by no means all. He sits there before me, hundreds of miles apart, at canvas, waiting for my hand to arrange whatever he then sees. I write, I think, I post for Michael to see, put upon. Thus enter into a partnership that has its daring objective, the rendering of perfect. For a time, seemed not just daring or unlikely or difficult, but even impossible. And so Michael, from the first he sees, has entered into a compact with me to assist in the arrangement of the words, which can so often be, well, recalcitrant and obdurate. And for this magic moment, we need magic music. Voila! Summoned the theme from each, composed by 1982. Fills my brain and lifts me. Lifts me, I too, am doing wheelies across the battered bicycle. Play it now and experience the joy of inspiration achieved, of being young, oh, so young again, filled with hope and joy that will take you, yes, it's taking you to wherever you have dreamed or are now on your way. I remember the first time I heard this story. It was in the balcony of the Harvard Square Cinema on Church Street, not even a 5-minute walk from where I am now writing to you. I heard it, and I have seen a place of wonderment and flying high joy. Then it happened. I started crying, sobbing. I looked at my oldest friend, Bob Dotson. He was crying too. He squeezed my hand, and we both experienced what only Hollywood at its soaring best can deliver. Total, if you are unsullied exultant. Yes, it was happening to me, to Bob, and to every man in the theater. Yes, even the men who cried, but were now, who never cried, but were now sniffling, sleeve to nose in unembarrassed happiness. We were saving E.T., doing the good deed, helping him go where we all want to go, home. Yes, we comrades, all and forever, we're all helping and get this fellow creature and friend home. Yes, we would help E.T. go home, though we would never see each other again. Thus, were sadness and joy mixed, as they are so often in life, the greatest triumphs and most devastating defeats, the work of a single moment. But we were not thinking of that then. We were glad to be alive and in the right place, a moment of sheer exultation and innocence, each moment to be and cherished till death, and perhaps not even then. Then this rare and precious moment was shattered by a girl in the third row, who turned sharply in her seat, the better to glare at us, every male present. "Shh," she said, "hush, you sissies." And that stern-faced girl, irritated, exasperated, spoke for every woman in the audience. And I learned that each gender cries at different things, and never the twain shall meet. Outstanding, Dr. Ladd. That's part of the excerpt from Dr. Ladd's new chapter he's adding, Jeffrey Ladd, COCEC. And we thank you guys for listening, and we thank Ms. Porter for recording. And this is the type of content, guys, we get, and you can get to, if you come and be a member of worldprofit.com. Let us show you how to build a business, and let us help you. Well, Mike Harris from Danville signing off. I think Dale.